The genesis of motorcycles, commonly known as Bodabodas, comes from reasons such as unemployment, whereby most people have gone into this trade because it is the easy way out. Also, you need to consider the fact that moving from one place to another is made easier by Bodabodas. The country is in a crisis of transport, and with all these reasons, the motorcycles keep on increasing in number. With the increase, the risk of accidents also goes up, and the impact can be seen in hospitals. In 2008, for a period of 3 months, a team of scientists from Makerere University College of Health Sciences, including orthopedic surgeons from Mulago Hospital, carried out a research to assess the impact of motorcycle or Bodaboda accidents on the budget for clinical services at Mulago Hospital.
About 60% of the budget of the money allocated to the surgical services in Mulago Hospital actually goes to take care of those who are injured by Bodabodas.
One patient costs the hospital a lot of money that can be used to treat patients with other diseases such as malaria.
We estimated that on each patient, if he stays on an average of 8 days in the hospital, it will cost approximately $400 on just one patient.
Injuries from Bodaboda accidents are mainly in the lower parts of the body, with majority being open fractures. According to the report, common causes include human error, which accounts for 80%, non-roadworthy vehicles at 10%, environmental factors at 5%, and poor roads at 5%. The Ministry of Health has admitted to having limited resources, including funds and a workforce. To help save the lives of the Bodaboda riders and other accident victims, the ministry is determined to improve emergency and casualty wards.
We saw what happened in Mulago, that Mulago has a better casualty unit. We want to do the same to all the regional referral hospitals, and then emphasize on hospitals along the highways.
However, more needs to be done to curb the rise of these accidents.
Keep in mind that road traffic crashes are really not accidental, that they are predictable and they are perfectly preventable.
There are social and economic costs, both direct and indirect.
Yeah, we spend approximately 30,000 a day. That is transport, going to get food.
If this person is going to be on the road for 35 days, as we've seen here, how much money has he lost?
The police say they will arrest motorcycle riders who do not wear helmets, which is one of the 5 risk areas identified by the World Health Organization, WHO. Lack of training schools has also been cited as a possible factor. Most people involved in traffic accidents, according to the report, are youths between the ages of 21 and 30 years. Florence Nalimba, NTV.